field right here. The red line is actually what we call the wellhead protection area. So the red line, we'll talk about this a little more, but the red line is bigger than the actual footprint of the well field because it kind of has to cover the area that the water is going to come from to get to the wells over a much longer period of time. We've actually modeled the wellhead protection area on what we call the 30-year time of travel. So we've got a groundwater flow model that says where our wells are, all basically north of Sandy Boulevard, but this point between I-84 and Sandy Boulevard. Run from about I-205 here out to Blue Lake Park. There's 30 wells. Actually, I think there's 30 wells, of which 27 are active. They're in the active wells are in three separate aquifers, and then there's a couple other aquifers that we're not actually using now. So, can you bring the rock samples?
Yes.
So I
wonder if
you can pull the aquifer thing. Everybody knows what an aquifer is. An aquifer is a geologic unit that bears water. It's basically aqua is water, and it's a Latin word that means bearing water. So an aquifer is a geologic unit that bears water. We've got some samples here. This is a very coarse gravel. It's got a lot of the two properties we need in an aquifer are basically porosity and permeability. So in that gravel, there's a lot of airspace right now. If this was below the water table in the ground, if all that air, free airspace would be filled with water. It's about 40% of that sample. And the pore spaces are really well connected, and the channels are really large, so water flows really good through a gravel like this. This is our best aquifer probably is out at Blue Lake Park. It's composed of fairly large gravels that are much larger than this actually. There's a couple other samples here.